everyone, and welcome to the currency buzz for this week. Talking about the last week, we had seen that the dollar rupee pair was trading in a very, very narrow range. We had a lot of events that were scheduled last week, starting with the RBI policy meet, wherein we had mentioned that the central bank is expected to cut rates by 25 basis point. They've also, changed their stance to accommodative from neutral. They've also revised their inflation and GDP forecast. So for the GDP numbers, they've revised their growth numbers to 7% from the earlier estimates of 7.2%. But we haven't seen much of a reaction as such on the rupee, and it was consolidating in this narrow range. If you look at the levels on the downside, 69.20, 69.05, that has been an important support zone. On the higher side, 69.80 to 69.90, so that has been an important resistance zone. So this 1 rupee band has been there for quite some time for the dollar rupee pair. We don't expect this range to be broken as such in this week as well. So we expect that this low volatile movement in case of the dollar rupee could still continue. In case of the global triggers, if we look at that, the trade deal between US and Mexico, US and China is still on the overhang. We have seen that some bit of developments has taken place between US and Mexico, wherein the US president has hinted that the talks are going at a good pace. So overall, we have seen that the dollar has reacted slightly positively this morning. Otherwise, it has been under pressure for quite some time. And if we look at the dollar index in the last few sessions, it has been going down against its major crosses. So we expect that for this week, if we get more developments specifically on the trade deal front between US and Mexico or between US and China, we could see that reaction coming in on the dollar index, and subsequently we could see the euro and pound getting some bit of direction. If we look at the euro USD pair, euro USD has seen some bit of upside momentum coming in last week, as I mentioned that dollar was under pressure, and we expect that this week, as we mentioned, that slightly low the economic calendar is slightly muted, and we expect that could keep the euro and pound both slightly sideways. But yes, we will have to wait for the final CPI number that will be released from the eurozone, and probably that could give some bit of trigger to the euro USD pair, which has been consolidating in the last few weeks. So overall, the economic calendar as such is muted, but yes, because of this uncertainty and slightly low muted economic calendar, we expect that Japanese yen could see some bit of reaction, as we've been talking about yen for quite some time now, that this uncertainty is leading to safe haven buying in Japanese yen. On the downside, 107.70 for the USD JPY pair, that's an important level to watch out on the downside. If we see a sustained break below that, then yes, yen could strengthen further, but otherwise 107.70 on the downside, and on the higher side 109 to 109.20. so this could be the broad range that the USD JPY pair could be trading in for this week. Thank you.